गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज डॉक्टर अनुजा सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, सीकेटी कॉलेज, न्यू पनवेल. सो टुडे आई विल बी टेकिंग सिलेबस ऑफ केमिकल काइनेटिक्स फ्रॉम एसवाई बीएससी केमिस्ट्री पेपर 2 सेम 3 यूनिट 1. सो टुडे वी आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम थ्योरीज ऑफ केमिकल काइनेटिक्स, आरएनएस इक्वेशन, कोलिजन थ्योरी एंड एक्टिवेटेड कॉम्प्लेक्स थ्योरी. So before that, let's revise what is chemical kinetics. So the rate of the reaction is we use to determine, and the rate is directly proportional to the concentration of reactant or to the concentration of product. So what happens with ongoing time, reactant concentration used to decrease as the reactant is converting into product, and product concentration used to increase. So graph is exponential graph. So coming to the Arrhenius equation. So Arrhenius equation in we used to determine the relationship between the rate constant of the chemical reaction and the temperature. So temperature is T here, rate constant, as I told, whatever the rate of the reaction happens, that we used to calculate as K. Rate constant is denoted as K. So this equation is K is equal to e की पावर a into e की पावर माइनस ea by rt. सो k इज योर रेट कॉन्स्टेंट, a इज आरएनएस इक्वेशन, e इज एक्सपोनेंशियल, ea इज एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी, डिवाइड बाय rt, r इज गैस कॉन्स्टेंट दैट इज 8.314, t इज योर एब्सोल्यूट टेम्परेचर. सो हियर एज वी कैन सी द रेट इज डायरेक्टली proportional to exponential of minus a by rt, and if we remove the proportional sign, we used to get some constant. So a is Arrhenius constant. So Arrhenius constant used to depend on many factors. So it is known as pre-exponential factors. So it comprises of mainly two factors, that is frequency factor and steric factor. So a is equal to rho into z. Rho is frequency factor and rho is steric factor and z is frequency factor. So what are these two? Steric factor means it's like steric hindrance due to the substrates that are present in the molecule. So and a is also dependent on the temperature at which the reaction is taking place, and a must be determined experimentally, and a is has a unit of order of the reaction. Order means like for first order reaction, the order for the order of the reaction, the unit is second inverse. For similarly for A also, the unit will be second inverse. Similarly for second order reaction, if the unit is L mole inverse, second inverse, so same it will be the unit for A. So next is the collision theory of chemical reaction. It is developed by Max Schwartz and William Lewis in 1916 to 1918. So according to this theory, the molecules of the reactants are assumed to be hard sphere, and the reaction are assumed to occur only when these spheres collide with each other. So here that we can see the term is collision frequency. It is number of collision per second per volume of the reacting mixture. It is generally denoted by Z. So what happens in this theory, we consider two the molecules as a hard sphere, and they used to come together, close together, and they used to collide. So because of that collision, it result into the product. So it may happen that all the collision will not result in the product, only the effective collisions will result into product. So here the equation that comes from the Arrhenius equation, K is equal to A e ki power minus ART. Here some the constant used to add up, that is Z, PQ and rho. So del PQ is collision frequency of which the reactants A and P, Q will collide. E is activation energy, R is gas constant, and T is temperature, and rho is steric factor. So here what is the activation energy? So activation energy is the energy that a reactant should overcome to convert in the product. Matlab, that much amount of energy should a molecule should possess that only it will the reactants will convert into products. Next is the next term is coming in the collision theory is probability factor. Probability factor means it should have some proper minimum energy, that is activation energy, and proper orientation means there should not be any steric effect hindrance. Then only and molecule should be properly oriented, then only if they will collide it will result into a fruitful product. So now the equation of rate constant will be rate equal to P Z rho e ki power minus Ea by RT. So let me explain this theory through a diagram. If you see there are two molecules but they are not properly oriented. So when they will come together there will be no product form. So now in the second diagram you see two molecules are coming together, they are in proper orientation, means they don't have any steric factor also. Also they should be having the minimum energy required, that is the activation energy. Now when they will collide they will form, they give us a product. So these are the few things that are required for converting the reactant to product. First is collision frequency, means they should collide with a some frequency that is required. Then activation energy, they should possess some minimum energy, and the proper orientation should be proper, there should be no steric factor or steric hindrance, then only the reactants will be converted into product. So this is activation energy. It will be more clear from this diagram. If you see the potential energy curve, with the progress of the reaction the reactor will convert into product. So if you see this energy gap between the reactant and product, this is the activation energy, means this much energy a molecule should possess, then only it will convert into a product. Now again there are some drawbacks of this theory. First is, like as I told, we consider the molecule to be a hard sphere and spherical. But what if the molecule is non-spherical, then this theory will not work. Second is, there should be a proper orientation is a condition for this. If there is no proper orientation, this theory do not explain what happened to those chemical reaction. Then we assume whatever the rate of reaction, it is proportional to the total number of collision per cc per second. But all the collision do not result into product, because there are some collision which do not have proper orientation or do not have proper energy, they will not result into product. So only effective collisions will be considered. Next thing is, do not account of fast reaction, whatever what happens when there will be a fast reaction and reactant molecule will have less energy if than the activation energy. So with this I would like to conclude RNS equation and collision theory. Thank you.